Now, contrary to popular belief, I don't hate Machine Gun Kelly at all. In fact, I actually enjoyed his last album, Tickets to My Downfall, that's what it's called, right? A lot more than a lot of people. I thought Rap Devil was actually pretty good and said some stuff about Eminem that has never really been addressed. And the guy even took a powerbomb from Kevin Owens. He's all right with me. So I go into this new record, Mainstream Sellout, with an open mind. Hey, he's working with Travis Barker again, one of the greatest drummers of all time. If you want to see this uncut, it's on the Patreon, as always, link down in the description for that one. Otherwise, let's jump in. So, what I mean about Travis Barker?
Yeah.
Part one, why is it so hard to live?
Part two,
I shouldn't have done what I did. Part three, everyone left me alone. I don't want to live anymore. Yeah. I'd rather be a freak than somebody's puppet. Release your leash. I don't belong in the circus. They cut each my wings. So, miss my name.
There's no
maybe needs a big chorus, but it's all right, man. Drums are brilliant. Okay, we've got the Blink 182 breakdown.
Summon them by mistake. Price you pay for entertaining. Can't just alienate me. I'm not the one you want.
I feel so
alienated, like me.
Drums, dude. Travis Barker on flames! On flames! The song was fine, the drums were crazy.
God save me, I'm fucked up.
I feel like he's a bit stuck in very similar melodies across this pop punk thing. Runaway?
60 years old, kicked out the hole. 60 years old, out on the streets. Mixed with the drugs created. It's a good night to be high. Sober again, sober again. Desert outside the light. Say hi, cause the government at the falls. Mixed with the drugs created. It's a good night to be high. Sober again, it's a lie. There are no one way to a lost world, God save me.
Yeah, this song's pretty good as well. I can't be mad at it. The drums drive it. The mix is really good, like it was on the last album as well, in my opinion. The drums just sound really rich and strong in the mix, and it just sounds very polished, which is what it is. Do I think he's the greatest pop punk or punk artist of all time? No, far from it, but I think this is enjoyable music, and what I like about it as well is the fact that there's a whole generation of, I guess, kids, although people probably listening to him are a bit older than kids now, that are getting probably introduced to guitars and drums and this type of energy and music through Machine Gun Kelly. And if that's a gateway to a bunch of different bands, then I think that's great, to be honest. So I can't be mad at it.
2, 3, 5.
Butterfly effect from the last 3 days now. Maybe if I had something to say.
Count to 10. I made up my mind this evening. I'm taking the last. Drink while my conscience eats me.
Okay.
I'm taking the last. Time is the last.
Very misery business overall. That's right, that's good.
Maybe if we went another way, I wouldn't be regretting the decisions that I made. I think my heart is history. I think I'm broken, nothing can fix me.
Song is good. That breakdown there was strange. It is very, very, very similar to Paramore, Misery Business, but it doesn't sound exactly the same. Not as much as that Olivia Rodrigo song did. But this bit was weird, where it's breaking down. Ollie Sykes is screaming, but it just sounded like someone doing Mongolian throat singing in the background. Now, Wheezy on this one can always go either way. Mount Rushmore when it comes to rap.
My head hurts,
and it comes
she
to rock.
A couple blunts of Percocets and dear girl. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Drug dear girl. Filled up with purple rain. My anatomy's made up of alcohol. It's that 7 day I was on Adderall. These ain't cavalry. Drug dear girl. Yeah. Drug dear girl.
Now, you could take this as a metaphor. I think it's sort of supposed to be like that, a metaphor for his girl, whether it's Megan Fox or some like imaginary girl in an imaginary scenario that's, you know, that's there for him and looks after him and makes him feel better. But if these are kids coming in listening to this album, I'm not massively keen on them listening to this song, but, you know, he's not a kid's musician. He's sung about drugs a lot, even on this album. But yeah, it's a pretty on the nose or up the nose.
I'm so in love with her, my hope, my drug dealer. I sell my soul to her. Got to all these nuns, sister, whole town just touched down. Fuck it.
See, I don't need lungs because I'm God to all these nuns.
My plug is my face. Somebody stole my charger. I wake up, yeah. My head hurts, but she
catchy, man. It's catchy.
I can't front. I want further, girl.
Oh, one more time.
No. Sorry, Wayne, not one more time for you. I don't think there's been anything quite as catchy or stand out as the title track or Bloody Valentine on the previous album so far. But so far, it's been a bit more consistent than the previous album. It's all in the same style. We'll see what happens with the rest of the record. And it's all enjoyable, catchy music with decent musicianship, amazing drumming. I can't be mad at it. I won't be mad at it.
Machine Gun Kelly's album. What's the album? What are you going to call the album?
I don't know who that was. Strange name for the track, because the chorus where he's saying leave the scene, you're ruining it, he's obviously just responding to a lot of the hate that he's getting for sort of moving into this lane. I can imagine some real hardcore scenesters in his community can't stand him being in here and doing more numbers than all the other bands, but I just see him as like kind of a gateway for these bands to get more listeners. I guess you could look at it either way, but mainstream Sellout, it's like, well, this isn't really mainstream music, especially these days, but you're kind of making it mainstream music, but you're not selling out to an existing trend. So I think it's slightly confusing in that respect. I think he's actually taken quite a brave move to move away from a successful lane and a lane that, you know, okay, fair enough. Maybe Eminem kind of destroyed that lane for him. So he moved in this direction, but I wouldn't say it was selling out myself. So that's what I'd say to you, Kels. Right.
Okay.
Song two.
Screaming when we fall.
Not now.
Screaming when we fight, yeah. Type, yeah. I could see that ass shaking.
Damn.
Yeah. Break up just to make up. You're gone when I wake up. Me, you make me feel so disgusting. Can't stop a runner from running. So go, go, go. You're my only drug. You're my only vice. Yeah. You're gone when I wake up.
This is not the best one, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, kind of instantly forgettable, that one, to be fair. Now, this one has been all over the radio. I think I've only heard it a couple of times, though, to be fair, this emo girl song.
I am a god.
I can see how this song drives people mad, and not in a good way, but...
She's got makeup by the mirror in her bedroom. Fishnets,
this is proper pop punk. Rock Show by Blink 182, like the Bowling for Soup song, the name disappears from my brain for some reason. I don't think this is the best song on the record, but I do think, controversial opinion time, I think Willow's better than her brother.
Emo girl, I fell in love with an emo.
What's the name of this song again?
Emo girl.
Oh yeah, thanks.
I'm in love with an emo girl.
It's so repetitive.
I'm in love with an emo girl. All I want is an emo girl. I fell in love with an emo girl.
Say something else. Say something else. Okay, don't.
Oh my god!
Oh my god!
Overnight, I'm a few sips from pulling the trigger. Self-abusive on the
solid album tracks, all right? What does 5150 mean? I could look it up, but it's always better when you guys tell me. I do think perhaps with, what, 7 songs to go, the album might really need to switch up a little bit or to have a real, real standout track. Listen, this isn't going to be the greatest pop punk album of all time, but I don't mind this music at all. I find it enjoyable. It's nostalgic for me. The instrumentation is good. It sounds good. I can understand if Machine Gun Kelly's voice annoys people. In this lane, it doesn't annoy me particularly. I think there's been far more annoying voices in pop punk over the years than his. Let's see where the rest of the album goes.
Mess it up, take my life, dress it up, sign a deal, I got paper cut.
Bit of a mix up in pace for this one.
Yeah, yeah. Don't belong, I'm a punk. Hello world, you fucking suck.
More of a Weezer energy. I was going to try and sing, but trying to switch key, and that would be possible. It sounds like a Sweater song from Weezer, but trying to hit the key would have been impossible. For me.
On these therapy sessions, even though I'm not showing up, I spend a lot of time healing my mind and my heart, but I still put these drugs in my gut. Me and my girl were just screaming at each other right before we both got out of the truck. I got some demons inside, I'm trying to free them aside. I found the cleaning inside with the book. I saw the limit and took it farther. I'm a genius, could have made Donda, but the song is for my dead father. Oh,
I'm a genius, could have made Donda, but the song is for my dead father. I think he's close to writing a really good song. And I don't mean that in a condescending way. When I say a really good song, I mean a really fucking good song in this lane. I think he's close. I think there's some of the music that has influenced him over the years, whether it's in this genre or, you know, he did the cover of Frank Ocean. I didn't like it, but, you know, it shows he has taste. I think there's a moment where hopefully he can just drop the shoulders a little bit, relax, and it really all comes out. And there may be a really great song in there, but he seems to find writing decent stuff in this genre quite easy.
The zombie apocalypse is not too far away. I think our robot is real, but I'm kind of afraid to say. Any thoughts in my mind?
There it is. There's ska punk. If we get some horns in there, I won't be mad. It's not, because this only happened the other day and this song would have been recorded for ages, but you could kind of take this as a little notice to Joyner Lucas and everything that he said about Lollapalooza, saying that he'd beat him up, basically, if he saw him, because he had the audacity to be booked to headline a show. Come on, mate. Joyner Lucas, no one wants to go to a festival and listen to I'm Not Racist. Just relax a little bit.
You don't need to go to school. Life's gonna kick your ass anyway.
Call me under.
Yeah, don't listen to Machine Gun Kelly.
You call your heart, there's lightning and thunder. Sun shines. I know better than to trust anything that I say to myself when I'm this high. Ay, 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 ay.
I don't ever wanna fuck.
I don't give a fuck. Ay, 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 ay.
That is what ain't really working for me, I can't lie.
I don't ever wanna fuck when I'm this high. When I'm this high. When I'm this high,
the Wayne again.
I looked in the mirror, who is this guy? Higher than Jehovah, highway to heaven. You know I'ma get pulled over. I'ma need a chauffeur.
Hey,
this is not a great song, but I think it's clever being 2 minutes as a pace breaker.
Pretty thing, but I see right through. You got a dark side. Well, I got a dark side too.
Hey,
I don't trust the soul, not even dead ones.
Dead ones.
Care.
I want you to know that you can't come. I want you to know that fake love don't last. So go ahead and know that you can't come back.
Very radio.
I want you to know that fake love don't last. So go ahead and
want to trade love for cash. Oh, whoa. She's been throwing shots, I had to catch one. Gamble with my life, I'm here to buy.
I wanna.
It's a catchy radio song. I'm sure this will end up on one of his singles. A thought, I don't know, right? If there's anyone else out there who's a parent, I don't know if the fact that as a parent, I've been through my kids being really, really young now, they're nearly 11 and 7, And you have to listen to the most horrendous noises. Not only them crying, obviously, but like the music that they want to listen to, the TV shows and the theme tunes that you hear multiple times a day, especially if they're watching them repeat. I think you just become a bit more battle-hardened to music that doesn't really do a great deal for you. Because if I'm comparing some hellish kids song or a theme tune to a show on CBeebies to this kind of like plasticky radio hit, this sounds glorious compared to that. I can imagine myself maybe, what, 16, 17 years ago, or maybe even longer than that when I was a teenager, and hearing a song like this and being like, ah, this is sellout shit, man. Where's the fucking edge? And I think maybe you just mellow a little bit over time. And maybe that's why I come in with a bit more of an open mind. In a song like this, I'm like, eh, whatever. It's fine. Other parents, let me know. Because, man, once you've heard that show me song, this is very for specific reference now to British parents. Once you've heard that 1,000 times, nothing can hurt you. Officially a better song than the Show Me theme song. Right, Gunner, Thug, and Landon Barker, who I'm gonna guess is Travis's son, on this one. Die in California.
Killed me, I used to be. I might die in California in my mind. Someone cut the lights off, please. I've been kinda sad lately. I know that I'm good for you, yeah. But you kind of tap with the Cleveland logo printed on my hat. Tell me, wasn't my fear of being complacent that ended up leaving me so jaded? I'm miserable even though I made it. Got a house in it.
You do wonder when you hear, I mean, Machine Gun Kelly talks like this a lot, but sort of projects a different thing as well. So you're like, do we really need to listen when he sings a song like this and speaks like this? Or is it a little bit like he's exaggerating? Because you do worry. Like, he's taking a lot of drugs. He says he's really depressed. He's really unhappy despite everything that's happened. He's having anxiety attacks every single day. If we actually listen, I mean, it's pretty straightforward what he's saying. He's saying this stuff. Do we need to listen? I don't want this to be a situation where we as an audience are either throwing pink tomatoes at him, or even his fans, we're just like enjoying the music and sort of hearing and maybe repeating what he's saying, and then go, you know, a couple of years down the road, he is fucking dead in a ditch. And we're like, fuck, we should have listened. So I don't know, man. Is it an exaggeration, or should, you know, does he need some fucking help? Anyway.
They gonna be missing me. It's gonna be chaos when they come out to my royalties. I keep this still like Mr. S, and that's by any means. Watch out for us, watch out for cause they good for anything.
Gunner is effortless on everything.
And I got demons on my shoulder. Heart getting cold, oh, so cold. Give me a heat.
I might die in California. Yeah, die in California.
All this bread, make up, speed up. When I did, ate up, I made a sit up. I don't talk to a pillar. I don't walk, rose, rush up. Tell the old ladies and the babies go inside.
Oh, she my baby, she my wine.
She tryna kiss her while we ride.
Why? We about to fuck around and die.
Fuck around and die.
Living in the hills, got high.
I kinda like this song, you know. I kinda like it.
I used to be.
It's overblown. It's ridiculous. Young Thug came with a completely different energy. I think I kind of liked it. Yeah. Own what you like. Own what you like in life. People might tell you that this is shit, this is bad, this is terrible, this sucks. Fuck it. If you like it, own it, unless it's hurting anybody else, of course.
I knew a girl who wear my t-shirts when she went to sleep at night. She makes sure I'm breathing in the morning.
Secret anymore. I'm inside. I let you take control. Where you going? Close my eyes. Coming with you tonight.
Body is it, don't stop holding. Now start the car, baby, and take me the fuck out of there.
It's a bit mid-paced, man.
If you cry, if we die, then we die. Let's go.
It's been 6 days since the last time I saw your face, and you asked my sign. I told you mine. I questioned why, and you said, hey, I want you only. Hey, I got 6 ways to say that I'm too bad to keep. I'm too.
This will be at someone's wedding. I don't think it's great, but it will be at someone's wedding.
You're too good for me.
And you know, congratulations to whoever plays this at their wedding.
Set you free.
Go on. Say what you want. I thought that song was bordering on the preposterous at one point, but it did pick back up. And if everybody in the crowd, his fans, are singing that song, and then that moment happens with the light show and stuff, that is actually going to be pretty fucking good. I can't be mad at the record, man. I enjoyed the record. Like I said, I don't think it's the greatest pop-punk record of all time, and nor was his previous one, but I think that was probably more consistent than the previous record. I just don't hate it, and I won't hate it. If you've made it this far, this is the place. If you love music, do subscribe. Let's get to 400,000 subscribers. We're on the way. And I really have a great day. I'll catch you all soon. Bye.